Well, nothing much to incrementally talk about except for the fact that there is pressure on the Bank Nifty as an index. We have the advance decline ratio for the third consecutive day, which is managing to hold up on the advances side. So that's a positive indicator, considering that the mid-cap index itself is a higher by around 0.4%. The advance decline ratio, for example, on the Bombay Stock Exchange stands at around 1,340 odd stocks advancing to around 600-650 stocks declining. That graph just went by for you. But we have Manisha Gupta joining in now to discuss all what she's tracking in the commodity and the currency space. Manisha, over to you. It's crude.
Oh, well, yes, and some profit-taking that we've seen come in there after every week of gains. The last 24 hours actually have seen some decline, and this is to the reaction to the U.S. data that shows that the U.S. production is at a record highs of 12 million barrels per day. This has been an increase of 2.5 million in the last 1 year itself, and U.S. with this number has left the other big producers like Russia and Saudi Arabia far, far behind, where the production is now just about at 11 million barrels or so. It is also about the export numbers from US, which have been rising. The US supplies also have increased for the crude output there. And the markets also are then looking at the strength in US dollar. That's led to some profit taking in crude as well. The US and China trade talks conclude today in the evening in Washington. So ahead of that, there is some choppiness that we've seen in asset classes. And then you also are reacting to the US capital goods data that came in weaker for the month of Jan. How do you put all of those fundamentals in perspective, and where are the crude oil prices headed from here? To get a sense on that, we are now joined by David Lennox. David, hi. There is plenty happening in the global markets, and then the demand supply number is something that the markets also are reacting to. What is top of your list? What are you watching when you're looking at the crude oil prices?
Oh, good afternoon. Certainly, you've mentioned some of those, and we're obviously watching very closely the U.S. domestic production. And as you have said, it hit 12 million barrels for the last weekly read. And we do believe that that is probably the point at which we think that U.S. logistics is at capacity. So we will be watching very closely there to see if there's any movement beyond that 12 million barrels over the course of the next few weekly data reads. If there isn't, then we do believe that that is the case, that logistically the U.S. is somewhat strapped by the amount of oil that they can move around, and that will, we believe, take some pressure off the oil price. The other we're watching, obviously, is closely what is happening in OPEC, and as the markets have probably been well aware now, their last data read, we saw them come in at around about 31 million barrels of oil production a day. And that's certainly below where they were expecting to cut their ceiling rate to. So from that perspective, with a lower OPEC number and an unfortunately higher US reading, one would expect that the oil price would probably lean towards what's coming out of the US, and we'd expect to see it rise. Fall.
Sure. So, David, what is your sense on the prices going forward? Because with the kind of cues that we are working with, if I put a broader range out on what we really speak to a lot of experts on the channel, it is 50 on the lower side, 75 on the higher side as well. Is that is that broader range that you're also working with for 2019?
Oh, no, we're certainly looking at a much closer price than for Brent. We're looking at between 74 and 84 by calendar year end. So we're still looking at the current prices. We've still got a ways to go to the upside. We will be looking for the global economy to actually stabilise through 2019, and that will, we believe, just nudge demand for oil up towards 100 million barrels, and that will be sufficient. With the curves that we've seen in OPEC production, and we hope US domestic production remaining plateaued at 12 million barrels, that should just give the oil price, we think, enough of a nudge along over the course of the rest of this year.
Hmm. So, David, one final question. What is your sense on the U.S. output then, and how much of pressure, or is this number really factored in? Because we've seen IEA report also suggesting that we could be going all the way to 12.5, 13 million barrels per day of a production as well. Have the markets taken it in? Would you say that it really is about the demand that will drive the prices from here?
Yes, certainly. If we see further production coming out of the U.S. up towards that that level, then one would expect that we would see further pressure on the price. Because as you've already said, the U.S. is brought in nearly 2 million barrels of oil extra production, and that's really what stopped the oil price from sitting between probably $80 and $90 rather than where it currently is.
Okay.
So look, overall, if we do see the that plateauing, and that we'd have to take the EIA numbers as perhaps we're wrong, and we will be seeing extra production, that's going to keep the oil price in check, and even our forecast for end of year could be in danger. But there's a lot of water to go under the bridge yet.
Okay.
All right, Manisha, as well as David, thanks very much for joining in, bringing us that view on crude prices and commodities.